Coming into 2006, BYU had lost 4 games in a row to Utah. And yet BYU was favored at Rice-Eccles Stadium because they had a really explosive offense that year. John Beck was a senior quarterback, and he had some great weapons with Johnny Harleen, McKay Jacobson, Curtis Brown. And so BYU came out and started well in that game, but made some mistakes and allowed Utah to get back into the game. Brett Ratliff, the Ute quarterback, played really well. And with just over a minute left, the Utes drove for a touchdown and took a 31-27 lead. So John Beck's career versus Utah came down to one drive from the 25-yard line. The biggest play on the drive was a 4th down pass to Harleen, covering about 17 yards and getting the Utes down to BYU rather down to the 40-yard line. And yeah, the clock just kept ticking. They got down to the 11-yard line. Beck tried to throw a fade pass to Harleen that Bryce McCain knocked away with 3.2 seconds left. So the Cougars knew they were down to their very last play.
Being that close to the end zone, we have our route. The route takes about 2 seconds to run. And then after that, you're just kind of running around trying to find an open space. So John kind of rolled out to the left. And as a receiver, when the quarterback starts scrambling, you just kind of follow them and find an open space is the rule. So I came across, I remember I kind of flashed in a hole quickly where I felt like I was open for a second. And, John didn't throw it at that point. He started making his way back across. And at that point, I'm kind of like, there's no room over there. And I kind of slipped behind the last defender. And so you just kind of go, it's almost instinct at that point where everybody just kind of flows with the play. You follow the quarterback. So all the defense did that as well. And I kind of just, some way just kind of snuck back behind everybody. And once it started flowing the other way, I realized, there's not much space for me over there, but if John sees me back here, he's got a strong enough arm that he can just turn and throw it. And I wasn't sure if he had seen me, but, when he tells it, he talks about he was kind of trying to lure the defense away from me. And so I was open over there for, a good long while. And finally, just as he was getting hit, he turns and just chucks the ball across the field to me. The way I remember it is sitting back there waiting for the ball. And, and at first I almost kind of misjudged it. I thought it would make it all the way to where I was standing. And I realized, as the ball is coming towards me, I'm like, it's not going to quite make it here. So I need to go up. And so I kind of slid in and it made it look real dramatic on TV by having to slide in and catch it just to make sure I secured the ball.
The basic idea was for every eligible receiver to run a route into the end zone and try to get open. Gary Anderson, the Utah defensive coordinator, used a drop eight scheme, which he swears by to this day that 90% of offensive coordinators would not want to go against that with only a 10-yard vertical window in the end zone. The only flaw was that the play lasted 13 seconds. So, to begin with, Johnny Harleen, the BYU tight end, was lined up way out to the right. Eric Weddle, the Utes' great defensive back, was lined up against him. So that basically took Harleen out of the play. But his route was to go straight into the end zone for a possible fade, which was the previous play that Bryce McCain had knocked away. So he gets into the middle of the end zone, and at this point, John Beck is shuffling to his left, almost to the other side of the field. So in a scramble drill, Harleen knew that what he needed to keep doing was just follow Beck across the field. Now at some point, he would actually violate that rule by staying where he was when Beck was flushed back to his right. But Harleen got to this point right in the middle of the U, about 6 yards deep in the end zone, when Beck started back to his right, and Beck insists that he knew Harleen was standing there as Beck ran back to his right. Joe Giannone, the Ute linebacker, did exactly what he was supposed to, which was when he saw an opening as Beck kept moving to the left, he fired out and chased back to the right, where Kelly Talavo, a Ute defensive lineman, was ready to corral Beck right about the hash mark where the play started. And Talavo wrapped his arms around Beck's waist as Beck jumped and threw the ball toward Harleen. Now, to revisit Harleen's path, he had basically gone past every Ute defender, about eight guys in a 40-yard jaunt across the end zone. And ultimately, Eric Schein was the last guy that let him go. But again, according to the scramble drill rules, Harleen should have gone back to his left to follow Beck, but he stayed here. And again, somehow, the Utes are convinced that Beck had eyes in the back of his head, because he seemed to be literally the only person who knew that Harleen was standing here. So Beck jumped, got as much on the throw as he possibly could, but it was short of Harleen. And so Johnny had to run up, and his biggest fear was that the ball wasn't going to make it to the end zone. And if he catches it on the green part of the turf, the game's over. But the ball makes it just far enough to where Harleen is sinking to his knees as he catches it. And he told me the next year that watching the replay the next day was the most agonizing moment of his life, because he was convinced that somehow he was going to drop the ball that he had caught the day before. And he also remembers being mobbed by his teammates and feeling claustrophobic and worried that he was going to make it out of that dog pile, but it was worth it in the end.
The next day, watching, you know, they showed the replay of it, and so we're over at my wife's family's. We're like a Sunday dinner thing, and the game's on. It starts getting down to the last few minutes, and just watching it, I just felt so much more nervous. Like, it's not like, you know, obviously I knew what was going to happen, but it's almost kind of like, oh my goodness, like, you know, this could have, you know, it turned out great, but it very easily could have, you know, been a horrible moment where, you know, everybody remembers you as, you know, the GOAT instead of the hero. So just kind of watching it that way, I was like, man, that's I'm glad that it worked out.